Welcome to our program. I'm Tony Noakes.
And I'm Dr. Wendy Walsh.
On today's program, we're discussing information that every consumer of pharmaceutical products and every user of medical devices needs to know. Information you most likely aren't aware of, but absolutely should know about concerning the medications you are taking and the medical devices you may be living with. Side effects that could cause irreparable harm to you or a loved one. Now, in this segment of our program, we'll be discussing potential side effects related to the chemical component gadolinium used in the contrast agents injected in patients who are undergoing an MRI. Wendy, as I understand it, MRI imaging is a commonly used diagnosis method because it provides information X-ray, ultrasound, and CT scans cannot provide. So what issues should our viewers be aware of regarding MRI imaging?
Well, Tony, MRI imaging is a highly effective medical diagnosis tool because, just like you said, it allows doctors to identify certain bodily tissues that are not identifiable when using an X-ray, ultrasound, or CT scan. And it also doesn't involve radiation. The problem, though, has to do with the gadolinium-based contrasting agent that's injected into the patient's veins. This agent helps doctors see and distinguish blood vessels from nearby tissues.
Okay, so what problems are related to this contrasting agent being injected during MRI procedures?
Well, Tony, studies as far back as 1997 and later in 2007 indicate that patients with kidney problems should avoid undergoing MRIs involving gadolinium-based contrast agents because it can cause a scarring condition that can lead eventually to organ failure and even death in some patients with kidney problems. Back in 1997, there was a study where 25 cases reported this specific scarring condition.
Wow. What causes this toxic effect on people who have been injected with this contrast agent during an MRI?
Well, the problem is the chemical component, gadolinium. It can be toxic if not eliminated from the body as quickly as the drug manufacturers promise. This puts the patient at risk of suffering serious injuries. Now, this is especially true of patients with compromised kidney function who, because of their condition, tend to retain the contrast agent in their bodies for a lot longer.
Wendy, that sounds really serious. So what symptoms should viewers who have been exposed to this toxic contrast be aware of?
You'd be amazed at the wide range of symptoms, Tony. The most common are tissue burning, pain in arms and legs, bone pain, stiffness in hands and feet, even cognitive problems and brain fog. Other symptoms might be swallowing and voice problems, low body temperature, even balance problems or swelling of the hands and feet.
That is a lot of symptoms. How soon after an MRI do patients experience these symptoms?
Well, it's different for everybody. Most people with gadolinium toxicity have symptoms within the first month after their contrast administration. For others, their symptoms start within a few days, and for some people, within a few hours.
Wendy, you mentioned earlier there could be life-threatening effects to this toxicity. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, this is the bad news. Over time, this can result in very serious conditions, including hardening of the lungs and diaphragm. And this affects a patient's ability to breathe, and in extreme cases, can even cause death.
Okay, so what has the FDA done about regulation of what appears to be a very dangerous medical product?
Well, the FDA has been trying really hard to protect consumers. The first action was done in 2007. That's when the agency added a black box warning to the packaging of their products, and they warned patients with diminished kidney function to avoid MRIs with gadolinium contrast. Then in 2017, and again in 2018, a drug warning was sent to healthcare providers, indicating the potential for gadolinium retention, especially in the bones, organs, and brain.
So with all these issues, I assume legal actions are pending.
Of course, this is America. A number of legal actions have been filed alleging patients were not properly warned about the risks associated with gadolinium retention.
Wow. Thanks, Wendy. You know, complications like this are not what you would expect after having an MRI. So if you or a loved one has had an MRI with contrast and suffered any side effects we have mentioned, call the number on your screen now, as you may be entitled to significant compensation for your injuries.